It's the first weekend of February, and for once, the weather in Middle Tennessee is just really nice. So, I had to take advantage of this moment, especially since the groundhog claims we should be in for an early spring, and I hit the road to get a nice sunrise view of Middle Tennessee and early morning rail action of CSX entering and leaving Nashville. I made it to the cemetery, eager to get set up and see what would be coming, and when I got set up, I was greeted by a lovely sunrise to admire, and little did I know, I'd be greeted by a pretty rare visitor, and I'm not talking about a train. Now that's definitely not what you expect to see coming your way, a skunk that is nearly entirely white. Needless to say, while I thought it was beautiful, I ran back to my truck and left my camera to admire the skunk for me, because I have never been sprayed before and I was in no mood to be sprayed now. After our little furry friend left, I saw a northbound approach signal indicating that whatever train was coming would likely be approaching slow and preparing to stop at the next signal. And that's exactly what happened as train number one, a northbound coal train, made its appearance at the cemetery.
Thank you.
All right, so what we just saw there, why that train was going so slow, it ran into an approach signal, that meaning yellow over red, that's what it was just ahead when that train was coming through. That being said, the train stopped just right up ahead of us here, stopped at the next signal. That signal means be prepared to stop at the next signal. Therefore, we likely have a southbound train coming now, any minute now, whenever, you know, it comes this way. Likely something coming either off the Henderson sub or the mainline sub, because right here is right where two come together, and it does split off to be either the Henderson or the mainline sub. So we'll ride around for the next train. Should be a southbound train coming any minute now. After the northbound coal train passed through to stop at the next signal, whatever he was waiting to come through off of either the Henderson or mainline sub made its way through as a southbound manifest made its way in, with a special treat to see as the rare CSX EMD leader was spotted, as CXXT 4562 SD70 was leading this train, running at a rather quick pace. After the manifest, action remained high coming southbound as CSXT 520 leads M209, a fully loaded auto rack train hauling anything from Jeep Wranglers to Chevy Silverados. I could see quite a variety of different automobiles through the small openings of the auto racks at times.
No defects. Repeat. No defects. Total axles 4, 5, 2. Length 1, 0, 3, 3, 2. Detector out.
Now, I believe that's all that I've got time for here today. It's been a pretty good, 2 hours. You know, we've only been here a short period of time. Saw 3 trains, and that's pretty productive. Saw a skunk, a pretty good morning overall. I might come back tomorrow, so hopefully we see more trains in part 2 of this video. As I returned the next day, it was more of a cloudy day after being blessed by great lighting on a sunny day the day before. And sat right in front of me was empty ethanol train B796, being led by CSXT 532, a rather old and heavily weathered GE AC44CW built in August of 2001, still sporting the Y&2 paint scheme today. For the time being, it's without a crew, as the last crew had just left when I arrived on the scene, and the replacement crew were still on their way. But before that could happen, CSXT 337 leads a southbound manifest on the opposite track. We'll be right back. soon as the manifest was clear, we were already seeing an approach medium signal on this track, meaning something would soon be lined to go north. As I continued to admire the beauty of the parked, empty ethanol train in front of me, a crew had just arrived to take over, and they were a friendly crew. We chatted only for a brief moment. They said they were heading north to Evansville, Indiana, and this train would eventually end up in Decatur, Illinois. The gentlemen operating this train worked diligently to do all of their checks before setting out, and in no time, off they went as they headed north to take the Henderson sub out of Tennessee. As they made their way north, soon the other train lined for track 1 was headed our way in IO-26, led by CSXT-5109 with a friendly crew offering a horn salute. And, before a long stretch of empty well cars, they are towing along a geometry car, actively scanning the rails. Check out the red light by the back rear trucks as it passes. In addition to the geometry car, we also saw a rear DPU on this one, something else that we just don't see as much here in CSX country, but it was cool to see. Once again, after IO-26 passed, we saw another northbound approach signal, and soon CSXT-867 leads a northbound manifest train with yet another EMD unit running second in CSXT-4753 SD70. To me, it's always really cool seeing those EMDs on the rails.
Thank you.
That was the last train I captured for a weekend between a morning session on Saturday and an evening session on Sunday, but as an added bonus, I was going to the Bass Pro Shops on Monday to pick up some items for spring maintenance for our fishing boat, and on the way in, I saw a coal train parked and wanted to see what it was. While it did not stretch to the cemetery, I did immediately see a northbound intermodal train making its way through, and eventually this train came to a crawl as it made its way out. weather definitely has continued to be a blessing so far after the cold snap in January and the tornado that hit Middle Tennessee in December, and the days to go railfanning are definitely getting much more favorable. With that said, I hope you enjoyed this weekend of railfanning in Middle Tennessee, and I can't wait to bring you along for the next adventure here on Danny B. Trainz. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like so the YouTube algorithm knows to show you and others more of my videos in the future. If you're new here and haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe and click the bell icon so that you never miss another video right here on Danny B. Trainz. Until next time, thanks so much for joining me, and I hope you have a great day. Bye, guys.
4 years and 1,400 miles between us. Seven numbers I just